Okay, the first method for finding an upper bound is very simple. It's simply the minimum spanning tree doubled. So to return to the starting point, you're just going to go over every arc in the minimum spanning tree twice. So let's look at that in example three. So what we need to do is to work out the minimum spanning tree. It does specify to use cross scores, which is annoying, but there you go. What we need to do first with cross scores is list every arc in the order of its size. So I can see two threes, I see an ID. We're meant to put that in square brackets if they're the same, it doesn't really matter too much though. See a four. Three fives that I can see, CD, DE, BF. And then I've got A7. I've got a couple of eights. A cycle. DA forms a cycle. DF, that doesn't form a cycle. We only need to hook up G now. It's a BD forms a cycle. FG, that's going to be our answer. So we've got AC, AD. CA, BF, DF, FG, and there's that tree green. Now, when you're drawing your tree, when you're doing root inspection, not root inspection, so when you're doing track and salesman, it's a good idea to do as long a chain as possible as a straight line. Like I can see from there, all the way to G, I can do a straight line. So, A, I, D, F, well then from F I can do B, G. Just helps massively when you're doing the later algorithms, if you do it like this. So the length of the minimum spanning tree is going to be 4, 7, 10, 17, 22, 30. So our initial upper bound is going to be 60. So it's literally going to be, well, there's like starting point A for example, A to D, D to F, B to F, F to B, F to B, B to F, F to G, G to F, F to D, D to I, A to C, C to E, E to C, and then back to A. So you've gone over every arc twice, which is why it's the minimum spanning tree doubled. Okay, not a great upper bound, which is why it's the upper bound, and we'll work out ways of producing it. Example four, we're going to do exactly the same, except it's going to be prims on a matrix. So remember, if you're starting from A, remember to cross off the starting row. And if I look down A, the quickest is A to B, and then look down both of them, and then don't forget to cross over the list of them, and then B to D, and then look down all three. 17. So it's going to be, Mel's pantry is going to be 24, 32, 46. So the initial, the bound, it's going to be 92. So that doubled. Okay, so what we can do is improve this using what's called shortcuts. It's the first way of reducing your upper bound. So rather than going back, 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 can we do it in a more efficient manner? Well, the most obvious thing to do is to join at your endpoints. So let's just see what that would do. So if you went C to I, to B, to D, to E, but instead of then going 14, 8, 11, 13, or back again, what if we went from E to C? And from E to C is 18. So we'd be adding 18, but we'd be losing 14, 8, 11, and 13. So we'd add 18, which would be 110. And then we're going to take off 22, 33. 46, which would give us 64. So that shortcut saved us, saved us what, 28. Okay. That's quite a substantial saving. So our initial upper bound was 92, better upper bound is 64. So you know the optimal solution must be less than or equal to 64. Okay, on to example 6. I think 6 is something that's a bit more complicated, you know, like something you've probably seen in the exam. And this time it does specify you must start and finish at I. It's a politician who visited all these cities started at I. So I forget to cross out I. One above it. Look down there. I presume 47 is the smallest. A to B. Down I on B. 84 is going to be the smallest. Down I B on C. Got 120 there. Not got anything smaller. I need to look down these three on that one. 131 there. Smallest. That's what EH. Look down for those. Careful, because I didn't actually check those. But luckily, 131 is the smallest. So, 17. Sure, it's going to be 17. We've got two rows left. So we can do this. So I've got a 220, I think it's more than that one. 151.44. Circles comes to 751. So initial upper bound that doubled, which is 1502. Right, so the question is, says to use shortcuts to get a value below 1300. Now, sometimes in the question, in the exams, they use a shortcut. So if you use shortcuts, you could be losing a mark. So Try and do it with one. If you can. I've got a problem because I've got A, B, I, C, I, E. Right, and then E, H, H, H. So you've got a chain there starting at E, so A to E. So, okay, so I'm trying to draw in one line there. So A, so E, H, so F, so G, to D. And you've got these two. So, A, B. So let's put those values on. 84, 47, 88, 120, 131, 70, 144, 155. Right, now, an obvious shortcut's going to be from the end point here, so D. So D to where, that looks good. So if you look across on D, so D 220 looks good, but that's DF, so I'm not much going. So really I want one of these, C, A or B. This one looks quite good, C, B, 42, although D, C, A is closer, that's an extra jump to C, and it's only an extra, what, 20. So, what did I say, starting from A, so come up to E, E to H, H to F, F to G, G to D. I'm going to do a shortcut to C. So that is, what is that, D to C? No, I didn't want to do that, I wanted D to B. Okay. Cross that one out. D to B is, where is it, D to B, 402, so that's a calculator. So, numbers handling will off, which makes life interesting, so 155 plus 144, so I'm just going to add all these up, I'm not going to be doing twice. So rather than going back, I'm just going to go straight to here. So that's what I've reduced, but I have added 402. So with just that one shortcut, I'm going to be at 1237, which is below 1300. So that one shortcut solved the problem. So that would be A to E to H to F to G to D to B, then to A, then C to A. Of course, what I could do here as well is rather than going to A to C to A, we would go C to A. So what's B to C? So B to C is 121. So that's what, 131. So that's size 10. So if I went A to E to H to F to G to D to B, but then C to A, that's 7/10, so then to 1227. That's using two shortcuts. Now, if the question was to get it under 1300, just stop there. If you, as soon as you get it under 1300, don't do anything else because you might make a mistake. So both of those are upper bounds, but the better upper bound, the ones I've done, I say the best of a bound, but the better of a bound is 1227. Which is better than all the ones the book did. The book got it down to 1237, which is slightly worrying. No, I've got 1, 2, 2. So. Okay. If you have a go at that, then exercise 5.